So now I'll be working out the problem number 12. So we'll just move on to the adjustments. Let us first go through the adjustments. The first adjustment is a dividend of rupees 26,000 was paid during the year 2014. So we will just look into the liability side of balance sheet just to check whether proposed dividend is given or not. So it's not given. So this means that this dividend of rupees 26,000 will appear twice. That is both in the, under the head operating expenses and also under the head financing activity. So profit before tax for the year is rupees 62,530. So this is the amount of net profit that we are supposed to pay, note down in under the head operating expenses. So one more thing that you have to remember is since we are writing profit before tax, that is rupees 62,530, which means that this includes even the dividend of rupees 26,000 and provision for taxation made during the year. During the year 2014, the company paid an income tax of rupees 25,000. So income tax paid is 25,000. We'll just look into the liability side of balance sheet. So they have given you provision for taxation. So opening balance is 40,000, closing balance is 50,000. So we have to prepare ledger account and record this adjustment of tax paid during the year rupees 25,000. So this is an important adjustment in the in this problem, students. And this type of problem we have already worked out under fund flow statement also. So this is an adjustment wherein the assets of another company has been purchased by the issue of shares. So during the year, the company purchased another company and paid rupees 60,000 in share capital. So it acquired stock and also plant. So there is, these are the two items which have been acquired by the company, which means that if you add these two, there is a difference of rupees 20,000, and this difference of rupees 20,000 is nothing but the goodwill purchased. If you just look into the asset side of balance sheet, so opening balance is nil and closing balance is 20,000. So which means that assets goodwill has been purchased of rupees 20,000. Now there is one more adjustment continuing to this. It acquired stock of rupees 21 and then 18,360. The another adjustment is it purchases machinery costing rupees 5,650 during the year. So this is purchase of machinery for rupees 5,650, which means that this amount should, this adjustment should be recorded in plant and machinery account. So if you go through these adjustments, the important ledger accounts that we are supposed to prepare are plant and machinery account, provision for taxation account, and also equity share capital account. First ledger account, plant and machinery account, write the opening and closing balance of plant and machinery account. So here there was an adjustment. It acquired, that is it purchased machinery costing rupees 5,650 during the year. So the general entry will be plant and machinery account data to cash or bank account, that is 5,650. If you just move on to the previous adjustment, the company purchased another company and paid rupees 60,000 in cash, in share capital, sorry. It acquired stock rupees 21,640 and also plant rupees 18,360. So purchase of plant by issue of shares. So this is the posting plant and machinery account data to share capital account. The amount is 18,360. So balance the account, students, and the balancing figure that you get will be 20,760. So this amount should always be treated as depreciation and not as sales. So this is very, very important. Whenever the assets of another company has been purchased, and the balancing figure that you get should be always be treated as what? Depreciation and not as sales. Now coming to provision for taxation account. So write the opening and closing balance of provision for taxation account. And as we have already seen in the adjustment, the provision for taxation made during the year was 25,000. That is, tax paid during the year was 25,000. Balance the account, and the balancing figure will be transferred to 35, that is profit and loss account, which is 35,000. This is the taxation provided during the current year to be paid in the next year. Now moving on to equity share capital account. So write the opening and closing balances of equity share capital account. So whenever the assets of another company has been purchased by the issue of share capital, so the journal entry would be stock account data, plant account data, goodwill account data to equity share capital account. So while posting in the ledger account of equity share capital account, by stock account 21,640, by plant account and by goodwill account. So if you balance the account, the equity share capital account will be tallied, that is 2,75,000. we'll post all the transactions recorded in ledger accounts to cash flow statement. So plus first one, you have plant and machinery account. Towards the debit side, you have purchase of plant by paying cash 5,650. This is an investing activity. So it comes under investing activity, purchase of plant and machinery within brackets 5,650. Now come, that is purchase of plant and machinery by issue of share capital. It is a non-cash item, so it need not have to be recorded in any other head of cash flow statement. So come to credit side, we have depreciation 20,760, which should be shown under the head non-operating expenses 20,760. Now we'll move on to provision for taxation account. So tax paid during the year is rupees 25,000. This amount should be deducted in the end. So 25,000 is the tax paid. Come to credit side of provision for taxation account. So we have provision for taxation made during the year 35,000. This amount actually, it should be shown under the head non-operating expenses. But here we have already taken the net profit before tax. So which means that this amount of 62,530, it already includes proposed dividend and provision for taxation. So you need not have to show it here. So this point you remember. Then coming to the equity share capital account. So we have towards the credit side purchase of stock by rupees 21,640. So this amount will appear under the operating expenses, that is issue of shares against purchase of stock 21,640. Move on to asset side of balance sheet. The goodwill amount previous year was nil and current year is 20,000. As all I have already discussed while discussing the adjustment, that this is nothing but the goodwill purchased by the company from another company, which has been already recorded in equity share capital account. Now come to plant and machinery account. This account has already been prepared. And come to land and building account. This again you have to keep it in mind, students. The previous year 1,48,500 is the balance and the current year it is 1,44,250. So if you just have a close look at the balance of the opening and closing balances, there has been decrease in the value of land and building. So as I told you, whenever the assets of another company has been purchased, then the any balancing figure should be considered as depreciation, and it will appear under the operating expenses or activities like depreciation on land and building rupees 4,250. Now come to current assets. So there has been decrease in current assets. So decrease in current assets, it should be shown here. So decrease in current assets, it is 27,800. It should be added. Now this amount of cash will be shown in the end. Equity side of balance sheet. So equity share capital, opening and closing balance, we have already prepared ledger account and posted into the cash flow statement. Now reserves, the opening and closing balance remains the same, so there is no transfer to reserves made during the year. Profit and loss account, this amount has already been taken. So if you are going to take the difference of this profit and loss account, which means that to this difference amount we are supposed to add provision for taxation and proposed dividend, but we have already taken the net profit as it is given in the adjustment, so nothing to worry about it. So provision for taxation, for this also we have already prepared ledger account. Then bank loan, previous year 59,510, current year nil. So which means that there is a repayment of bank loan which will come under the head financing activity, repayment of bank loan within brackets. Now come to current liabilities, previous year 73,280 and current year 52,660, which means that there is decrease in current liability. This amount of decrease in current liability should be deducted, decrease in current liability, so 20,620. The adjustment, the first adjustment is dividend of rupees 26,000 paid during the year 2014. This amount actually it is supposed to appear both on under the head operating expenses and also under the head financing activity, but under the head operating activities we are not going to show. Why? Because the profit before tax 62,530, it already includes dividend and tax. So this 26,000 is directly taken under the head financing activity as payment of dividend 26,000 within brackets. Now the second adjustment is profit before tax, which is nothing but the net profit which I have shown here 62,530. Then during the year the company paid a tax of rupees 25,000, so this amount should be deducted here, less tax paid 25,000. And the fourth adjustment we have already considered, and fifth adjustment is also over. Complete this cash flow statement. So now we have cash inflow from operating activities 91,360, and cash flow from investing activities 5,650, and cash outflow from financing activities 85,510. So the net increase in cash is rupees 200, and to this we have to add opening balance of cash rupees 7,500, and we get the closing balance of cash rupees 7,700. As you all know, this amount should tally with the amount which is given in the balance sheet, closing balance of cash 7,700. With this, we'll complete this problem.